Pupillary light reflex pathway. When light is shone in one eye, both the pupils constrict. Constriction of the pupil to which light is shown is called direct light reflex, and that of the other pupil is called consensual or indirect light reflex. Let's first discuss the afferent pathway. The outer segments of the rods and cones are the receptors for both the visual pathway and the light reflex. When light is flashed on the eyes, the pupillary fibers run in the optic nerve. From there they cross in the optic chiasma and reach the optic tract. From the optic tract, they leave the visual pathway fibers which continue to the lateral geniculate body and reach the pretectal nucleus. The pretectal nuclei are connected to the Edinger-Westphal nucleus on both sides. Half of the postsynaptic fibers from the pretectal area curve around the periaqueductal gray matter to terminate in the ipsilateral Edinger-Westphal nucleus, while the other half cross, mainly via the posterior commissure to the contralateral Edinger-Westphal nucleus. This connection forms the basis of the consensual light reflex. Each pretectal neuron functions as if it gets similar input from each eye and projects similarly in each Edinger-Westphal nucleus. Form Edinger-Westphal nucleus rises the efferent pathway. Preganglionic parasympathetic myelinated fibers from the Edinger-Westphal nucleus now go to the ciliary ganglion via the oculomotor nerve. After reaching the ciliary ganglion, they synapse there. Then postganglionic myelinated fibers pass through the short ciliary nerves to innervate the sphincter pupil. Normally, postganglionic fibers are non-myelinated, and this is the only exception to this rule. These are the parasympathetic fibers. If you find this video helpful, please hit the subscribe and bell buttons. And don't forget to like and share this video. Thanks.